Hola, amigos. Ghost here, and today we're continuing our Let's Play of God of War. And we're continuing straight from last time, in which we're here to resurrect Mimir's dead head. Which, if you can see on screen, it's at the bottom screen. He's kind of dead right now. You gotta revive him. And we're stopping by to Freya, or the witch, as she's referred to at the moment.
Their needings upon all who trespass.
Oof. Now, if I remember, this over here is the way we originally came to the witch's place. Yep, and that's where I think we met. Actually, I think we met the witch like right here, but we had to go through here, through all that fog.
Read it.
Sir. Death to the Raven God, Lord of the Hanged.
Pretty sure that refers to Odin himself, since he uses ravens a lot. Oh shit! The power! Seriously, this fucking thing, I love it. It's so fucking overpowered. It may not be able to kill like a dozen enemies, but it's able to kill just damage enough or kill a specific enemy that I need dead. Ow. Oof, there we go.
Better.
We can't use this until I think we can't find the seals until this is activated, which I can't really activate until I get the Blades of Chaos, if I remember correctly. Yep. I think. Those mess with two of those things. Unless I'm able to fucking just somehow big brain it, figure out the password without having it fully activated.
Here, boy.
I know those runes. That's Vinder. When? Must be for that sand bowl down there.
No, let's get down there then. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I can't do that one until get the Blades of Chaos. Because when I get the Blades of Chaos, when we go to Hell, It gives us that one power thing. I forgot what it is. Technically, the winds, I think, of hell.
What does it say?
Falcon, hawk, and turtle dove. Swim aloft in oceans above. Ah, wind. Vinder. Look what it did!
Bam. Get some goodies for that. A new attack. Runic of the Storm of the Elks. A lot of runic happening, but not much damage or stun. Prefer the wolves or the crow since they give a lot of damage. I'm big on damage, trying to kill the enemy as quickly as possible. Is there anything else over here? It doesn't look like it. Guess we can go to the witch's place now. Try to break this crystal. Can't go up there, that's just a crack. I like this turtle. I very much like this turtle. but let's see, anything else real quick? Doesn't look like it, because we came from here. Yep, time to go meet the witch. Wait, what? Oh, I wouldn't have seen this. Oblivion stone, a stone. Found in a treasure map. Okay. Stone of Frosty Mastery. Increases all frost damage inflicted by... I didn't know that there was a treasure map here. I think it's all in the goals. Yeah, we got all of them except for one at the moment, which is Don't Blink, which I'm pretty sure is on the mountain, but in an area we haven't been to just yet. I think I could always go back there in another episode. Granted, we do have to go back up there at some point for the story.
Father, she is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Hemele! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Oh. Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the witch in the woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either. Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are god.
Leader of the Vanir, once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
But...
Now!
You're welcome!
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your council head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The World Serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
It's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
Like, his just one breathe is an entire fucking paragraph. But I love this cutscene. This shows a bit of character from Mimir, the homie, the head. I just find it funny that he's just a head now. But also, it kind of shows that Freya... It hints at the future of what's going to happen in this game. But it also hints that she kind of forgot, or not forgot, didn't notice that there was a piece of the mistletoe arrow still on Atreus's bowstring. I guess we could assume that she thought that it obviously was there to fix the bowstring, or not bowstring, the piece of rope that helps with the quiver. And that they'll fix it and then get rid of that. But that could also just be her just not paying attention carefully enough, even though she naturally pays attention carefully a lot. All right. We've basically explored majority of this cave at the moment, with only a few areas we can't really go to until later. So we're just gonna move on. We're gonna use this. But yeah, Freya, I believe, is Odin's wife?
Oh.
One of the main, the big top dog gods in the Norse mythology, if I remember correctly. Like, Mimir refers to her as Majesty. So, her Majesty, so... Maybe? I'm not sure. I'm not too familiar with the Norse pantheon of gods that much. I know some of the Greek gods, I know some of the Roman, which are basically Greek gods, but Roman.
Why did Freya spit in your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken.
I mean, we did fucking chop his head off. I mean, Granted, I don't think the brain starts decaying that quickly, so I'm not any fucking expert on that shit.
Mimir, we're on the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Well, yes. That's what we have to do. And if I remember, when he calls the world serpent, the water decreases more and there's more stuff to look at from this point on, I believe. From that point on, I mean.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally, that horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn.
Like I've been summoned to talk.
Why is he doing that?
Odin had that statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. He remembers me. Why you? Oh no, that's not right. Mokuno Huntunkun. Ahon Eko no Tunno Vunora. Knows the pain of your loss. He will help you. Curious.
What is it?
Nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're headed in the right direction. Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one on the peak where we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looks kind of mad for a moment there.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
So he was drunk every time he talked to him.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
All right. Where the fuck? Holy shit, the serpent is fast. I mean, granted, we see later that he's pretty fucking fast. But my man's is really the homie. Anyone think you could just vibe with the fucking giant world serpent? My man's really just trying to vibe. He's just chilling. He literally is just fucking chilling. Granted, him just fucking moving around the fucking lake caused a flooding, so... I mean... Yeah, there's... It's a little, what's it called? Sad that he when he moves, people die, but,
We get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Okay, why the fuck is that bridge allowing me to go? That is weird. I mean, she did it for the other side. But why would this side need it?
Which way to the chisel?
Boat under the bridge, keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
So he's referring to what the fucking... I'm pretty sure he's referring to right here. Like, we have to go through that. But I'm not going to do that. As today, now that because all the lake is cleared out, the rest of this episode will probably be exploring the rest of the lake to grab collectibles, things to upgrade ourselves with, and all that jazz, because you can never have too many upgrades.
An entire city under the water.
Aye, lad. A forgotten city.
What was it called?
I forgot.
It's so old, such an old city that he forgot what that existed. Makes sense. Oh! Dewdrops! Another one.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore, but a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
See, I knew it, as she was married to Odin. That made... But I'm pretty sure in regular Norse, she's a regular... Just a regular part of the pantheon, not a different god. I see that fucking troll. Oh god. Crack my neck. Let's fucking do this. Oh shit! I hate when they do that. Oh fuck! Oh, this is a tough area. This is a very tough area! I don't know how I'm alive, but I'm alive. Oh my god, that was a single hit. That was a single fucking hit. Alright, back on the boat. Back on the fucking boat. Let's get the fuck out of here. That was a single fucking hit. I've never seen... That area is too strong. That area is too fucking strong. Oh my god. I fucking got bodied in one fucking hit. I was full health, and then I wasn't. I think we could go in there, but we're gonna go here. That's a whole... I mean, those things aren't that hard to kill, usually. I mean, as long as you have a, piece of cover to get into like that.
Boy, over here.
Hurry up and grab it before he realizes we're here.
Treasure map. All right.
All right, let's try to collect this while he doesn't pay attention to us. Just yoink.
Hey, it's a fragment of a language sign. We should look for more like this.
Hi, buddy. One hit me. Okay, it's a very powerful boss. We can kill it. I just have to avoid fucking its attacks at all costs. So, I mean, we could try it one other time. Behind the pillar.
Get up, brother.
Okay, I think it's time for our tactical retreat. We got the chest at least, but we'll have to come back for the ancient himself. So note to self at the moment, these areas are fucking hard already. Gotta love it. You gotta love it. Alright, let's go this way. This looks like a whole new area. The Northern Gorge, I presume, is what its actual name is.
We're not getting in there without a key.
And we don't have the actual key for it. Alright, well, at least we now know that there's something over here for side content. Yeah, there's a fight for the Soul Devourer. Alright, we'll keep going along this coast, and... Alright, so far, two areas that have very tough sets of enemies. The boss isn't too difficult, it's just if we, were slightly more leveled to where we could take probably two hits, we could probably win. Maybe. I'm being a little more optimistic with that fucking, thought process, but I think we could survive if we were just slightly more stronger. And we got a defensive one now. Hang on, let me look at those real quick. Okay, so there can be different ones. So this one, I got two of them, is for cooldown, and obviously this one's for defense. Okay. I love how we gave this to Brock, but yet we still have it in our inventory. Same with the Dragon Tooth. I mean, I guess you could say it's a trophy, since we still have it. Of our accomplishment to that area. And looks like there's another dewdrop immediately in a fucking dark-ass cave. Looks like we can climb up that.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. the peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Never trust Odin. I mean, the only one you could technically trust maybe is the MCU version.
We're not getting there without a key.
I think we need a specific side quest to open up for either for just this one or for the other one as well, because those both are blocked off. Or at least we know where they are. And granted, even if not, we're not getting too much exploration in terms of like actually getting upgrades. We are finding like these dewdrops, which are important because they're permanent increases to stats that we wouldn't normally have permanent increases, since we have to change armor and equipment to keep upgrading our stats. But those dewdrops give us permanent stuff. Same with like other things like the Mark of the Dwarves and shit. Alright, let's go up here. Since it looks like there's something up here. After we climb up, that is. Oh, this is the back of one of the, gateways. Didn't know you can get back. I knew you could get back to a specific one. You can open this? I'll try that in a second. But I knew, like, very specific ones you could get behind. But I didn't know which one it was. And it looks like it's this one. That I mentioned, like, we could get behind from through there, like, back there. But it was actually up here. I just didn't remember it was this one. Alright, time to fight some fucking high-tier enemies that are strong as shit. Oh, they're fucking werewolves! And they're level 7. Okay, that's a thing we cannot fuck with right now. I feel like almost half the shit we can't fuck with, because it's just too strong. Yeah, let's not mess with that, but we can open this to see what happens. Oh shit, it's a traveler.
Tears braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it. He wouldn't.
I don't think we can, Oh, we have to find the traveler. Dog. That did shit to him. Okay, that's some bullshit. I think I could beat him. Compared to the boss, he has a specific moveset that if you know how to dodge, you could beat him even if he's overpowered. I'm gonna give that one more try. Got your ass.
Looks like we got them all. What do we do with that?
We will show it to the dwarves.
Whew. I told y'all I could do it.
Tears, braziers. A symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.
Indeed. Can you translate them, boy, or...
Yes, you can. I've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read.
Okay, they're from the new cipher we just started collecting. Got it. Alright, let's get back to the boat, because I am not trying to die from those werewolves. But yeah, with the travelers, I think they all have the same exact moveset. With like maybe one... Hang on, let me get back up here. I see that fucking raven. You ain't fucking... Get your bitch ass here. Fucking ravens. But yeah, like I was saying, I think they all have the same exact movesets with slight variation, maybe. I'm not 100% sure. I think I know one or two of them have, like, the ability to fucking sprint, and it's terrifying on this difficulty. Because they will do it at any point, and it's just like, fuck. But from what I remember, they mostly all have the same exact moveset, which makes it a bit easier to react. It just, for a second, I had to take a second to remember how the moveset worked.
Okay. Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Freya end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than his.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities, and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
I mean, you couldn't predict Odin being that fucking retarded as a person. I mean, granted, he's not retarded, he's just an asshole. I mean, you can only do everything you can do, and you have to hope that those who are at top of you, or what's the word, your leader will actually, you know, lead the proper way, instead of, fucking cause bullshit to happen.
Both are free. Eric.
Grab that first, and then we'll talk to the fucking spirit.
Are you okay?
No, son. My goods are underwater. My men are drowned, and yet their bodies continue to walk the beaches.
Hellwalkers. They plague these lands.
I was their captain. They died because of me. But these abominations sully their memories. I will find a way to free them from their tortured state. In this, I am determined.
So basically,
a thunderstorm scattered all three of my ships across the lake. I know not what I did to anger Thor, but his judgment was swift and brutal.
We will help you out. I guess Kratos doesn't mind helping him out in this case. Where are they? Okay, so they're over here. We've been over here a bunch of times. And technically, I think this also is... I think that's the captain that was mentioned by one of the Brazier spirits down here. And I think we get a bunch of goodies from completing this. Granted, I do not know how difficult this fucking area is. We'll see to that in this, when we go over there. But let's go into this cave. Oh, God.
Prepare yourself!
There's three of them! Oh, fuck! That one okay, that wolf is a one-shot, while the others aren't. Well, granted, I think I had only half my health.
Opportunities for hunting and trade in these lands. I gave up my search for Jotunheim long ago. Leave that for the younger, more hopeful men. But I was over-eager. And my men paid a heavy price.
Don't worry, my guy. We'll help you out after I deal with these fucking wolves. Bam.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. Treasure map. All right.
Another treasure map. All right, let's get up here. Let's see what's up here. Doesn't look like there's much other than this. Which we'll go back down to collect. Oh. Second one. Oh, that's why we have this room to hit that. Hey, everything doesn't look like it. So let's climb up here and see what's all the way up here, and then we'll climb all the way down to collect those, things we threw. Oh, we've been here before. This is another one of those brazers that we discovered. Wait. Okay. Oh, okay, well, an update, folks. You know how I said previously in a very early episode, you can get back behind here and do shit? And then another episode I said, no, you can't do that. Well, in fact, I was correct the first time. So we actually were able to go behind here. Wow. I really should listen to my fucking first instinct more. Because I was correct the first time, but then I'm like, no, there's no way. It doesn't make sense. Wow. You gotta love it when your fucking mind's like, no, you actually were right. Ay, caramba. But at least now we know. A confirmed answer. Now we can get down here and grab the last of the loot. Well, mostly Hacksilver. Then we can move on to more stuff. Make sure I'm close enough so that gate eventually opens up. Definitely not fighting that tear anytime soon.
I felt blessed to lead such a loyal crew. We'd become a family over the years. And now, my family is cursed.
Don't worry, we'll deal with it soon enough. Probably not in this episode. I mean, maybe. That is technically close to where we're going next. Because we're going to be like... Granted, we don't have to go over here. We already completed all this shit. But we'll just go around to make sure everything that we have been to has been completed. Lookout tower. Huh. I didn't know there was a lookout tower there.
Boy, what a sad story.
Yes. we should help him.
Really?
You are surprised.
Well, yeah. I didn't think you'd care about helping a spirit.
Fighting more Hellwalkers is good experience for you.
Ah. Oh.
You really thought Kratos gave a shit? This is the entrance to the ravine that we've been to already. But real quick, is there any dewdrops at like the beginning of it before we actually go inside it?
Amir, there was a shrine about a giant lady, lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Groa, the knowledge keeper. She was a gifted sorceress who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy that she might find her lost husband, Arvandil. But it was not her husband she would glimpse in her visions, for it was Groa, seeing longer and farther than any before or since, who witnessed Ragnarok, the end and the beginning. Odin caught word of her ultimate prophecy. He maneuvered to obtain her knowledge and hoard it for himself. Groa knew Odin as a longtime patron of her services, and so she welcomed him into her library as a friend. What she did not know is that Odin himself was behind her husband's disappearance, having used his enchantments to conceal his death at Thor's hands from her sight. Smiling, jealous Odin took her by the throat, and with his very hands he stole her library and her life for his own.
I always knew Odin was bad. That's just...
ruthless, barbaric, heartless? That's Odin. In fact, we would do well to sit here in silence for the next few moments and reflect on Odin's capacity for cruelty.
Which is a lot.
And so...
reflect longer.
Reflect longer. And back on the boat. Here comes a lot more mechanics. Now, we could go in here. In fact, let's land. Let's land here, and I'm gonna check time as well as save, and then we'll continue on. After looking at the time, we have a couple minutes left to explore. We might not try to fight off the Hellwalkers just yet. Because there's a lot of them, I think, if I remember correctly. But we can look around and see. Aha, there it is. Damn it, I missed it. Hang on, I think I have to be over here to hit it. Really? There we go. Got it. And another chest unlocked. Bam. Yeah, there's that we can end up getting up to, and gotta go over here. I mean, we could probably fight this encounter depending on how many there are. There's a couple of them. Ow. The power of the Kamehameha is too strong for him.
Father,
I'm almost dead. Jesus Christ.
Father!
Okay, I think I can actually beat them very quickly. It's because they're Frostwalkers, I always assume that the punching is better because technically because this is an ice-based weapon, they're not used to it, because I think even the game says it. But it seems like because it's an ice-based weapon, somehow it's doing a shit ton of damage. Didn't do too much damage to all of them, but...
at the
Oh shit, he hit me from fucking century away. Like, got fucking shot from across the country. Fucking firing mortars at my ass. Bam.
Were all those guys part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
Oh, no. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
Some more material for upgrades. I think this leads back to the boat. I don't know why I thought it didn't. Let's get up here. A lot of gold and a chest. I think we can get around it by going up here.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Okay, that's going in the journal.
Okay. Oh, there's a area over here with a chest as well. I missed that. Let's go. And collecting. Bam. More stuff. Now we're starting to get collectibles. Oh, climb. Rotate around, climb again, and bam, we're on top. We could go that way. I think it has to be straight. Yes, it's this fucking mechanics. There's a thing that we could technically get up there, but we'll go up here real quick and see what's up here. Because this whole area is to explore. This is the brazier that we were on set. That we've already cleared this whole area out. But it does give us potentially a chance to hit the fucking, what's it called? Nope, it doesn't. But we can use that to actually get behind it. Just like we could use this now to go all the way to the other island. And there's a dewdrop over there. And another one. So many things to collect and upgrade. I love it. It's one of my favorite things in some certain games. To just explore and grab upgrades and just become strong as hell. Even if, it like in this case, this difficulty, you're not that strong. You're going to die a lot. It's still a very much an enjoyable thing to do and get the upgrades to become more powerful or at least strong enough to survive specific combat challenges that we'll have to face against either bosses or random encounters and such like that. But yeah, I'm gonna end the episode there. When we come back, we'll continue on with the exploration. We'll grab that chest that's down there, come back all the way up and do this shit. It's a very complicated puzzle, even though it's not really a complicated puzzle. It's more timing, I guess, because there's also that tear in space that we have to collect, which I think in this case it doesn't send out enemies. It's just you have to be right, you have to time it to make sure you grab it, because I think these go back up eventually or back down depending on where they originally were. But yeah, hopefully you all enjoyed today's episode. I certainly did. Until next time, this is Ghost signing out.